Oh, hi. Hey, welcome back to Gen X Coffee Talk. Look who's here with us.
Hello.
That can only mean one thing. It is Record Poll Wednesday. And as always, brought to you by Palm Tree Radio. Of course, palmtreeradio.com. Go, listen today. The link will be in the description. Great station. Since it is Record Poll Wednesday, the wife is here, which means you get to pull us a record this week. Let's see what you get. Okay. Oh, going back to the back. Good middle. Oh.
I feel like I'm playing the piano.
True.
They're so heavy.
You can put, there you go.
This one.
Oh, you're going to like this. Open your eyes.
Yay, Billy Joel. Oh, Glass Houses. Can
we
I talk?
Yep, we got to show it to, here's what she pulled this week, Billy Joel's Glass Houses.
That's actually the house I was living in at the time, which is right near Teddy Roosevelt's house in Oyster Bay. And I saw the photo and I said, you know, people who live in glass houses shouldn't throw stones. And that's, the name stuck, Glass Houses. I said, that works. And as a matter of fact, the beginning of the album, you hear a glass being shattered, which is the picture on the back.
Can I see the back too?
Now, she knows all about this record.
I do. So, fun fact, this was the first Billy Joel album I ever listened to because my dad made me memorize all of the words to You May Be Right, and I could probably still do it right now. You may be right, I may be crazy, but it just may be a lunatic you're looking for. I'll stop there. 1982. Mm-hmm. So, I was 12 years old when this came out, which is when I was very heavily into listening to music with my dad. Sometimes a Fantasy, great song. Oh, Don't Ask Me Why. I didn't know Don't Ask Me Why was on here.
Yep.
Still Rock and Roll, All for Lena, I Don't Want to Be, wow, Sleeping with Television On. So this is just basically the perfect Billy Joel album. And fun fact, Billy Joel will be in Indianapolis with Sting in February. So if you have not seen him live, go to StubHub now and get yourself tickets. I think they're already sold out.
If you're near Indianapolis.
And if you're looking for a great birthday present for this one, he would love tickets to Billy Joel, just so you know.
The thing I remember most about this album, and I don't know how many of you out there will remember these, there was a bubble gum that came as looking like a record album. It actually came in the record jacket. It was only about this big, but I had this in a bubble gum record in a bubble gum album cover. I don't even remember what they were called.
Thinking about marketing, do you remember the record store at Honey Creek Mall in Terre Haute?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so the disc jockey.
Yeah, so this is the first display I remember really seeing at Disc Jockey because they had this picture kind of all over the window, and then they had the album and the cassette, I believe.
Yeah.
They were cassettes at that point. Yep. Just a huge, big display, and they had, like, fake glass, and I just remember going to the record store with Dad and seeing that display. So
there you go, folks. This week, she drew Billy Joel, Glass Houses.
Yay.
Fantastic album. Good job, honey.
Thank you.
So, good job. And in the meantime, as always, prost.
Prost.
Oh, that is a good cup of coffee.
So yummy. Good job. Kiss me. Mwah.